What are our expectations in the last 20 seconds, boys?
God. I have no clue.
I also have no clue.
Wumpa League, baby. Let's go.
That's the one. That if there's one thing I'm hoping for, it is Wumpa League.
Crash 4, baby. I mean, Spyro 4, baby.
Crash 4.
You already got that, baby.
I've got it twice now, baby.
Yeah, you got it more than once.
Oh no,
I really did.
Offensive content.
Oh no, my discretion.
Sid, did you end up putting your camera in front of you, or did you not do that yet?
No, I kind of rushed at the very end because I woke up at 7:08.
I just put it in front of me. There he is.
Ah, it's the big boy in the big day out.
Jeff Keighley's big summer game out.
Big summer blowout.
Big summer blowout.
Yoo-hoo. Ukajima.
Who would be watching this in an IMAX theater?
What?
Gamers?
Did he just say few hours? And yes, have a few surprises along the way. How long?
Excuse me?
He just said for the next few hours.
What are we doing? Play on Xbox, PC,
PlayStation, Switch, I guess we're mobile, watching. We'll have games for you. It doesn't
matter your platform of choice. Well, at least he said Switch before mobile. Mobile.
I'm glad I didn't record this in 4K.
Yeah.
I'm doing mine in 1080.
Yeah, so. Here, like Call
of Duty, my webcam doesn't go over, so. New teams, and
we'll make room for small independent developers who we think deserve the spotlight. I love when he did the little, like, finger to the thumb thing, like, independent, like, showing how tiny they are.
Independent. They mean nothing to us. But we've got a lot of good
stuff. So let's get started. He looks pretty excited, almost as excited as for Peggle 2.
He is very excited.
Jeff is weird, right? He's either presenting and he's the most excited person you've ever seen, or he's off camera and he looks like he's just killed a goose.
He's recharging his energy for this. Also, two of those names are not like the others.
Ryu looks like Giga Chad.
He does.
He do.
Oh, gameplay premiere. That's exciting.
Hell yeah. You see they added a thing so, like, in the versus screen before the fight starts, you can move your character's head around.
What, like, look around?
Yeah, like, pull faces.
It's
stupid. Oh,
shit.
Oh, it's Gwilly.
It's Guile.
Everyone's so buff. Gwilly.
I like it's bright and vibrant. I like it.
I do also like that.
It's Gwilly Gweechin.
I'm glad that we finally reached the end of, like, every game must be super gritty and grey. Color is nice, and we need to use it and appreciate it.
Yeah. Games don't use yellows and greens enough.
Oof, he did his downbeat.
There's the yellow and green.
Hey, that's the downbeat, yeah.
Is this Splatoon?
We're a kid now, or a squid now.
Damn, Guile kind of had a bit of a bald spot right there.
I mean, he's getting on. In his gold age. That pun didn't work as well as I wanted it to.
Oh. Is that a knife? Ooh. But a comb? Knife.
Oh, it's
comb?
A versus and a six.
Yeah. Bill,
my moment.
Behind us again.
My fight. Your fight.
Fun.
I probably won't get it because I'm not good at Street Fighter, but that's fun.
Yeah, I'm not good at anything fighting game.
Give me a platform fighter, please.
There you go.
That's all I must say.
Brand new game announcement?
Like that, yeah.
Brand new game
announcement? Ooh, brand new game announcement. Right away. Throw it in.
I love that
what is that?
Yeah, for the recording it won't, but I just love that it sounds like Billy's talking into a fan at all times.
I apologize.
Billy, can you just say, I am Iron Man?
I am Iron Man. Our mission was to end
That's funny.
I have moved my fan, by the way, just out of fear that it was that, but I didn't think it is.
It's Billy Billboard.
You actually do sound a bit more normal now.
Oh no.
You actually sound perfectly fine now.
What the hell?
Oh. Well, let's hope that it wasn't
an Aliens game?
It's Crash Bandicoot.
And that would be Sega if it was Aliens, wouldn't it?
Yeah, you're right.
I feel like this is based on a movie. I've got a
horrible feeling that this is a Tom Clancy game.
Oh yeah.
No, that looks like an alien.
But at the same time, yeah, like the gun thing made me feel like it is alien.
Oh, it's Dead Space.
Oh. Wait, no, oh yes, not. The Dead Space remake, maybe.
No, it's not.
Isn't it?
No, no, it's not.
Oh.
I thought that was Isaac.
Oh, it's alien. There you go.
Oh.
Can you trust my fucking gut?
I'm sorry.
I know movies.
Me too. Not very well, though, apparently.
2 degrees, and he's like, oh no, it's Crash Bandicoot.
You imagine instead of the alien popping out, it was just Crash. Like a hyper-realistic giant Crash.
It's the man in the suit.
Yeah.
Chasing you down like you're a Wumpa fruit.
What the fuck is that? Bars. Why did you just drop that on us like that?
What?
What?
That's just dropped a fucking bar on us, dude. But I know
when I close my It's the man in the suit facing you down like you're a Wumpa fruit.
Jesus.
You're gonna die, sir. Oh, he's already dead.
Really? When's the EP out?
I need to learn instruments first.
Will it feature DJ What's-His-Face with a pub fight?
With You Wanna Go Mate, the
with,
song.
Yeah, with the You Wanna Go Mate song as a bonus track.
Oh, it's just... Ooh. Oh! Aliens, specifically. Oh. So it's based on the
like
game.
A tactical, this does not look like a tactical twin-stick shooter kind of vibe from the trailer.
No, no. It looks more like a survival game, but I feel like that's way overdone, so I'm into that.
I enjoy the classic like overhead. That looked like it was co-op.
I like how it's based on specifically aliens.
Mm. There's more than one.
I mean, they'd have to be. There's multiple. they wouldn't call it Alien 3 if there was 5 of them. Philip Schofield? The Schofield cut?
Schofield.
They released the Schofield cut of GMTV.
GMTV.
Oh my god. I can hear the music now.
Imagine if one day they just released a Schofield cut of GMTV. It's not even GMTV anymore, is it? Or is it?
No. No, it isn't.
Good Morning Britain cut.
It's Good Morning Britain, yeah.
The Schofield cut, it's just all shot in 4x3 and occasionally black and white. Just to cover his grey hair.
Well, frozen people.
He's in his space suit.
Is this the thing? I don't know.
Oh, this is, the something... Callisto Protocol?
I'm just going through 80s horror films now.
It's Matt Damon, the video game.
This is Call of Duty Black Ops 3. I'm just trying to
give you a chance. Give me a chance at what? Oh.
Oh.
It's Kayati Mundi. He's got two brains. Oh, no, never mind.
Now, if you told me this was Dead Space, I might have believed you.
Yeah. last event, I think the PlayStation event, I thought it was Dead Space and I was wrong and it was the Callisto Protocol.
Yeah.
And this is definitely the same trailer or similar.
Yeah. It's a trailer for the same game.
But what about the droid attack on the Wookiees?
There it is.
It sounded like a Star Wars alien, that weird zombie thing.
Babu Frick.
That's Babu Frick.
We just have a collection of shitty Star Wars names. Woohoo! Babu Frick. Octo Bogdo. Chubo Quay. It sounds like a language at this point, doesn't it?
It does. It really does.
Oh, he's
Star Wars
that
is
guy.
His own language. Oh god.
Oh my god, he turned him into a poo-poo.
He turned his brain into a poo-poo.
In the wind!
Was that like one of those like really drawn out death screens?
I guess so.
Probably.
You know, where you die and you have to sit there and watch him kill you for 5 seconds. After you die.
Yeah,
the Last of Us kind of vibe.
Just like Crash Bandicoot. Right. We know what you
wanted to see. Just like Crash 1.
Yeah, but those are funny. All,
No, I, yeah.
If he crashed, he'd get his head beaten.
I wasn't trying to start a debate about Crash being annoying.
He falls down and then it goes, his shoe fell off.
They fly off.
Up in the air and it goes, woo! Which is weird because it implies he lands and then throws them up before he hits the ground.
There he is, it's Philip Schofield.
There he is.
There he is, just like I remember.
This Tony Soprano looking motherfucker. What the hell?
Yeah.
He do be talking with his hand, though.
He do be talking with his hand. He got the gold chain on.
It's about you guys. I appreciate that. Thank you so much. And yeah, it's so fun to do these shows and to show.
Humble Jeff.
People saw the trailer, but what I'm so excited.
Jeff is shitting himself. He doesn't want to be whacked.
He doesn't want to get whacked.
Yeah, have a rare humble.
I want
Jeff
Keighley dead. I want Kojima dead. I want his Game Fest dead. I want his barbecue ended. I want it rained out.
His barbecue. His summer day out in the sun needs to end.
His adventure in Hyde Park done. It rips him apart. It's great. That's how Londoners solve the day when the sun's out. I got a massive fucking bite on my arm, jeez.
That's the summer experience.
Yeah, you can see it on the camera.
Just for a second, COVID, through everything else, the dedication, the hard work. You guys are amazing. Thank you very much. Well, Glenn, I gotta say,
fucking spiders.
What you guys are shipping this year, this looks like a world class.
I haven't listened to a word these guys have said.
It's rare that teams are bringing something out like this.
It's a nuclear place.
Let's let the footage speak for itself. Ben Schofield, striking distance. Here it is, the first gameplay of the Callisto Protocol.
Ooh. That's cool.
It do be in space, and there do be dead. There's dead.
It do be pretty dead here.
There's a dead.
Real dead, Jim.
We just smacked him.
Yeah.
I hate it when my programs come alive.
Do be fighting like a monkey.
How come they have like...
Monkey?
I'm going CinemaSins mode here. They have holographic fucking projectors, but they're produced in 240p.
Ding!
Yeah.
What?
Ah!
Oh, oh god. What? Oh,
there he is.
It was a hologram?
Cool.
There's a guy.
No, you've got a grabbing gun.
You've got a
it's like
gravity
mod.
Yeah, gravity gun.
Oh no, big guy.
This is Gary Space.
Gary Space.
Gary Life.
Gary Life.
Hit him in the toes.
Yeah, shoot his legs off.
Kick her in the balls.
There you go. He's wiggling.
Oh, he's gonna be throwing back on the ground.
He do be wiggling.
Sir, he's throwing that ass in a circle.
I just saw someone say in the live chat it's morb in time
in the
for no reason.
Side. I mean, it does look very morb.
Does it?
I'm tired of the morb joke at this point.
Yeah, it's dead.
It was fun for like 3 days. Ironically,
it's been
3 days
like three
after like a
weeks.
Month.
Yeah.
No, it was dead for like the first month and then it resurged. Ow.
Yeah.
Spitty.
Oh! Don't spitty at me!
That dumb spitty stole my limb.
Stole my bitty ball.
Oh.
Shit.
That gave me Bulletstorm vibes.
Oh.
We need to play Bulletstorm at some point.
Oh no.
Oh, he's lost it.
He lost it all. That was very... That was a bit extreme.
Yeah, that
came out of
nowhere. Rewatch Kingsman 2.
Oh, he's on his holidays.
All right, moving on. This October, Call of Duty
his big
Modern
day
Warfare
out to
arrive.
The beach.
Infinity Ward is once again returning
he's in the sand.
Modern day action game, and today we're about to show you the world premiere of its gameplay.
Ah, here we go.
Oh, okay.
You can tell he's fancy. He's got his pinky up while holding the mic.
To check in
Hell yeah.
Oh yeah. That's how I hold my cup of fucking coffee.
I want to see if right the now. Engine same. It's how I do everything. I fucking vape with a pinky out, like... I'm hoping the engine is, like, updated a bit.
I hope so, too.
Identical for the last
three
games.
We usher in a new era of Call of Duty by giving you a game with the exact same name as one of the previous games.
Literally. Like, they've done three different Modern Warfares, and they all have slightly different names. This is the second Modern Warfare 2 with the exact same title.
It's just kind of funny. I'm interested to see it, but it's just really funny how they just can't think of any more names.
To be fair, in terms of like marketing, Modern Warfare 2 brings back a certain feeling to a lot of people from a certain time.
Yeah, exactly.
Like my brother's gonna hit. I told my brother about this when it got announced, and he was like, "Oh, what's it called?" I was like, "Modern Warfare 2," and he's like, "Again?" And I'm like, yeah. And he's like, oh, yeah, boy.
That's what they're hoping for. They're hoping for that reaction, you know?
Yeah.
Can you imagine if other game companies did stuff like this? Like imagine Nintendo.
They do.
Imagine if Nintendo did it. They're like, oh, yeah, we're releasing Super Mario Sunshine, but it's just a completely different game.
But isn't it just a
Super Mario Sunshine?
This is a reimagining of the first
it's
one.
It's like a
I don't know what to say. The first
it's the
one?
Same characters. Basically, you get right. The same characters in the same kind of world, but they changed the story and they changed like it's a whole different.
So it's
narrative.
Like a Final Fantasy VII remake kind of situation.
I don't know.
Maybe.
It's more like imagine if you got the same characters but they're just doing a different mission. Different goal.
So it's a DLC.
This is the another situation in the multiverse.
But it's weird, because like Cobb now is trying to tie everything into one not tie everything into one story, but like before, so like COD used to be like alternated between two studios, right?
Mm-hmm.
So 1 year it'll be these boys who do the Modern Warfare, and then the other would be the Black Ops lot, and then they added a third, and their games are dog shit. I don't know why they keep doing them.
Oh, but,
like you'd have characters that'd be in like one series, and then they wouldn't be in the other.
Oh.
Like the Modern Warfare characters will carry over, the Black Ops characters carried over from their old World War II game that he did.
Hmm.
It was all kind of cool. But recently, like, Cold War came out, which is by the Black Ops dudes, and they, I say recently, it's like 2 years ago.
He just shot his friend.
You're in Russia, and you just meet a young version of a character from Modern Warfare 1.
Oh.
And it's just there, and it's like, oh, cool. And then because of Warzone, they're kind of adding, like, all characters from both series into one, so it's kind of like a unified thing now.
Okay.
Which is cool. If you know like bits and pieces of the story, you can be
gun.
Like, oh, that did sound good.
I was like, whoa.
This looks good. I think this is the first like fully next gen COD.
What, like not on older
like,
gen?
Like wasn't designed around previous gens.
Yeah. I see what you mean.
It looks nice.
I think the Call of Duty I've played was, I want to say Black Ops. I could be wrong, but I did also.
What do you remember about it?
All I remember is like the opening mission. You're in a car, and then you get out of the car.
That could be a lot of them. I feel like.
Then
are you
get
in
out
like
of
a
the
bar
car.
And then you run to a car?
Possibly.
That's Black Ops 1. If that's the case.
Oh, that was right then. There you go.
I feel like most of my experience is just like playing the zombie modes in a lot of the games.
Yeah, boy. Zombies like, undefeated. Except
it is.
This year, they're absolute fucking dog shit. We've reached a new low.
I did play one of the ones on the DS as well.
Oh. got some like Metroid Prime Hunters controls.
Mm. Yeah.
Oh, we need to play COD Zombies. I want to talk you through the fucking lore.
Hell yeah.
I want to sit you guys down and spend 18 hours discussing the entire lore that was packed into 40 survival maps.
There is a lot of lore.
That, it just gets crazier and crazier. It's like, oh yeah, cool. Raising the dead.
Did you just say Ashwell?
Maybe.
You did. Because I misheard that. You're talking to the guy over the radio who goes, Ashwell, we got a problem.
You're in this? Yeah, like the zombies thing. It goes from like raising the dead to teleportation to time travel. The multiverses, to the multiverse is fractured, and there's pocket dimensions, and there's hell in one dimension, and there's Cthulhu monsters that have been controlling everything from the start. It's ridiculous.
Jesus.
I love it. And then the universe gets rebooted again. But they're still there.
The hell, they just jumped their little boat onto the big boat. Hell yeah.
Hell yeah. Also, Brian Blessed is in the level, and he sounds like Brian Blessed.
I mean, this do be a Call of Duty game.
This looks like
Modern
Warfare 1.
It do be a long-range shotgun moment.
This is literally the first mission of Modern Warfare 1. Or very similar. This is some pure wet work vibes.
Oh, you're getting shot there, buddy.
Oh,
now
that man's fallen.
Stand up there.
Yeah, why would you get up there?
Wanting to see the band better. I don't know if it's just like a coincidence, probably it's just a coincidence, but like, every time a new COD comes out, I normally end up, as a kid I get them on release because you don't want to miss out on the fun times with your mates.
Yeah.
And even the recent ones, like, my brother's bought them for me because I'd be out somewhere and he'd be like, I'll send you the money, buy me one, and buy one for yourself, lad. Yeah, so, like, every time I've bought one, it's been raining, and I love the rain, so I don't know if I'm just having like this positive nostalgic experience every time I play a game, because I'm like, oh, I'm comfy indoors.
Might be, it might very well be.
I'm looking at this and I'm feeling comfort already from the rain.
I felt like they were way too into close a car. To those explosives.
Ka-chow.
Ka-chow.
Get early access to the classic. Wow.
Oh yeah.
That's what we're talking about, and joining us
it's
now,
Luigi
from Long Beach, Johanna, great to
you.
Fireflower
Luigi.
Fireflower Luigi.
So we saw that and that's Mario, the guy from
looks
Infamous
the movie.
Second Son.
Oh yeah.
Oh shit, it's Nelson Rowe. Where is that set in the game? What
are we seeing there? Absolutely. So first of all, we're really excited to welcome back Captain John Price and
so they renamed GMTV to GM Call of Duty, I see.
You know, they're not yeah. Really in what we just saw today.
Yeah. Pick up the younger demographic.
141 and then the other two characters that were you may recognize from the older franchise that we're reimagining are Simon Ghost Riley and of course Soap John McTavish. And then a couple other
characters
in here that we're really excited that we got to create for this game. First, Commander Philip Graves. And
trying to find a way to say Luigi's kind of attractive without making it sound weird, but I couldn't think of anything. Really
hey, yo, Luigi, that you?
Who's just as important as Task Force 141. But as far as the level's concerned, you know, this, I got a shout out to IW. You know, this was a tremendous collaboration across all of the
modern Luigi disciplines, too.
As you saw, everybody coming together, some really motivated.
Deossified Luigi.
And, you know, you saw the wind and the animations and the awesome sound design, and of course, our new water tech, which is actually pushing the boat in different directions.
I always feel weird saying I look forward to Call of Duty's because, like, it's such a fucking big opinion to be like, oh, they're bad.
I don't think I, like, from high school, it's just because, like, everybody fucking played it and no one would talk about any other game. I kind of got this, like, not hatred for it, but, like, I'd hear it and I'm like, oh, I just don't care.
You know what it is? COD is just, like, the standard, like, the average balance for a shooter. So when it's good, it's like, hell yeah. And when it's bad, it's like, what the fuck? You have the most money.
You're gonna see incredible rendering, incredible graphics, all the things just within the game itself. Thank you, Luigi. Now, across Warzone and Modern Warfare 2.
Luigi is a graphic designer.
A lot of chatter and interest about graphic design is his passion.
Mario, I made you a new logo. Experience of Warzone for current. I think it's pretty cool. It's a wah. You fuck, Luigi.
That's a piece of clip art, Luigi. You didn't make it.
You didn't make it. You stole that from Twitter, Luigi. You didn't make it. I mean, so it's just a big moment, and there's going to be a lot more to come in the months to come. I follow the artist, Luigi.
You didn't give credit.
Yeah, when we're seeing that from the community, we love when the fans can pick up some things. Some chatter about maybe seeing
I want to see what the new co-op mode is going to be. We will get into
the details of Warzone. I imagine Call of Duty, but with two people.
Oh, this is Warzone 2.0, so it's like a complete new Warzone. Interesting.
Is such an important title for all of us, looking ahead. And like we said, we're having a bold vision around the entire future for the franchise. So we're in position. We're really excited.
All right, well, we're looking forward to October. Thanks so much for giving us a first look at the gameplay. Call of Duty, Modern Warfare.
Oh, wait, it comes out October.
All right, well, we've got lots more Summer
That's
Game Fest still
early.
And now it's time to announce a
do they not usually do it in late September, October?
It's usually November. Years after its
first release. What the heck are we talking about right now? This Nova old 6, PC baby. Game? Ooh.
Bro Fizz.
My quote. Oh, it's
The thingy.
Oh,
what the hell is it called?
I also cannot remember. Really
I know what
it's
called.
I know what it is, but I cannot remember what it's called either.
I'm getting the wrong names in my head. I'm getting Journey to Silius, but this is not Journey to Silius.
It's bothering me that I can't remember. Show me!
Oh my god, it's the Xbox!
Flashback.
That's what it is.
It's the Xbox!
It kinda does look like that, actually.
It's a Series X! There it is!
It's been shrunken! It's the Series Z!
Alright, let's turn back time. Back in 2017, we announced Witchfire at the Game
Awards. The X Cube.
Almost 5 years later, I am so excited. The team at the Astronauts in Poland has put together an in-depth look at the gameplay of this dark fantasy first-person shooter, which will enter early access.
Ah, another first-person shooter. Let's go.
I'm so excited to play this, and I bet you will be too after you see this.
Thomas, don't be bigoted against FPS, man.
Well, everything's been an FPS so far.
Just because you've never seen a first person shooter. We just had Flashback, you dink.
Yeah, for 30 seconds.
I will say.
Look, it's Bloodborne.
I also agree.
With me or Sid?
With you, Thomas.
Okay, there we go.
I want some different angles.
Alright, Billy, no more Doom for you.
Yeah, I like Doom. This is like Doom, but with like ice power or something.
Yeah, and you don't want to. It's like Bioshock a little bit.
It does feel more like Bioshock.
I was thinking Skyrim with guns.
No, this is Bloodborne with...
Is this a rhythm game?
No, it was just timed with the music.
It was just really well timed for a second. And I've seen a load of games recently that do, like, shooting in time with the rhythm.
Yo, I want this. This is giving me... This is scratching that Bioshock itch.
My humor is broken because he shot the bell and I just heard the Taco Bell bong.
I need to see what the chat's saying. Bioshock, Destiny.
Oh, I actually closed the chat.
The Modern Scrolls.
Modern Scrolls.
He's going towards a wiggly.
It's a wiggly crystal.
Oh, he's crossing his arms. Not arms.
I'm interested.
Saying it twice. Gonna find out if this early access is nice.
Yes. Epic now. Games Store.
Epic. He's in the Epic Games Store. He knows what's on your list. Okay, next. Why am I making it Santa themed? It's fucking June. Starring some very familiar
names. Enjoy this world premiere new game announcement. If I see arms,
European devs.
If I just see some arms, I'm gonna be upset.
I see Crash. That ain't Crash.
It's not gonna be.
Just a modern retelling of Crash in like an RPG, but he's got like a super serious voice. Dr. Neo Cortex. Oh.
Everything okay? This is fucking... What is it with all these games about dudes in spacesuits walking places?
We're going through like the what's it? The decade cycle right now.
Yeah.
We're doing space dudes.
We got
dudes,
the Dead Space remake.
We got some zombies.
We got Callisto. We got fucking Returnal looking ass.
Oh. But where's Metroid Dread? Neo Cortex?
Metroid
Bandicoot. Something's going on here. Oh, dude, it's the Martian featuring
Mr.
Matt Damon.
Solace.
Oh.
Huh.
It's got names at the top. That means they're taking it serious.
That means they want to treat it like a movie.
There he is! The guy that liked NFTs until we didn't like NFTs.
It's the guy from everything.
It's the guy who's in that game that got leaked today. Welcome to the show.
Good to be here. I gotta ask you guys, who are your characters in this game?
Well, I get to play...
I gotta ask you guys, what the fuck was that?
Roy Baker's a handsome man. I wish he never left Retro Replay.
I was just about to say the same thing. He's very beautiful.
You're very well dressed as well. In opposition with
Roger's character. The battle we've been waiting to see.
Yeah. Oh,
what
man.
Discord? What do you want? We've been
working on. And by the way, Jeff, this looks awesome, man. Yeah, it's man. So great.
I don't even
to
know.
Thanks for having us.
Thank so you for the notification that didn't even show me anything. Like, love that Discord.
One of the first major ones. I'm gonna go grab my bandana because I really hate how fat my forehead looks.
Okay.
Not a simple call away. I gotta ask, I think a lot of people will see this thing and they'll probably wonder, you know, it's a new team, right? Independent studio in Europe that's making this, but with huge production values. I'm curious, like, how did you guys get attached to this? That's better. I just looked over at OBS and I was like, damn, that's a forehead.
Damn. First, I mean, obviously we had this unprecedented event with the pandemic. Thomas on the headwear gang.
Everything as a society, but also it's because my hairline's like Vegeta, so it makes my head look huge.
Widow's peak, it is.
Yeah. I want a
Billy,
flat hairline like this fella.
Are you in headwear gang?
No. Unless you count headphones.
No, because we all are.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, you wearing your lucky, unlucky hat?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Because my hair's a mess and it keeps it in place. It's a
tight thrill. Thomas, I'm going to apologize to editing you because I was just typing for a second. And that picks up on my mic.
Now he's got to do something.
Bold of you to assume I was going to rewatch through this entire thing and cut stuff out of it. And
me. That's not bold of me to assume you would do that.
Not if this thing's going to be 2 hours long, good God. All the new innovations that
This seems like it's going to be a bit, right?
Who says it's going to be just 2 hours?
Oh, God.
We don't know. Where's my phone?
I really like how this is just E3 without the suit, without the like audience, basically.
Yeah.
A press conference without the audience applause. We're going to be discovering, like we said, it's a very tight thriller. So you're moving very fast. We are the audience. Multiple locations,
multiple ways for you to. Okay, it's going to be lasting between an hour and a half and 2 hours. And
then the narrative is a huge element to this.
They didn't waste any resources on the performance for sure. I got to according to Big Jeff. It was one of our favorite moments.
There was a lot of action in this. Big Jeffrey. That was at the forefront of this. And Billy Jeffrey. Aspect, we brought
in an incredible, I guess, new stream held on Twitter Spaces.
Billy.
Show as a whole. Anybody watching this can just look below and see, but like, and so, we're in the past. Don't blame me. Said, these are who our characters are, and he goes, give me 1 hour and I will come back to you with the story. Depending on how the event ends up playing out in real time. It was
like a recovery program. Yeah, because there's like live elements, isn't there? I guess.
Yeah.
Because this fella's not showing up.
Depends how much my guests, waffled about.
Jeff's like, depends on how much they fucking talk.
I do like some waffles, me.
Troy, stop talking, lad. Go back to Retro Replay and talk there. Yeah, I mean, we're
excited. Stunts, yeah, stop being in everything.
No, keep being in everything, including Retro Replay, YouTube.com.
Thank you, Troy Bolton.
It's not the same having Nolan North play with his son. Which will feature a musical
score by industry legend. Yes, it does. It's not quite the same as Warwick Davis. What?
Billy is interesting because the Doom composer, dude.
This is going to be some banging tunes, lad.
So it's just going to be intense, probably.
I was making a Warwick Davis joke. Oh, God.
Why is that fish on the ground?
Why is it plugged in? Why is the fish plugged in?
The fish took the orcs.
How many games are taking place on a planet? All of them, probably. But how many are taking place on other planets? Oh my god, another spooky game in space with scary things happen.
Scary cables.
I like how it's sort of. It has like a weird found footage filter to it.
Yes, it's almost like the Blair Witch in space.
With a. Square gun.
That was a good time.
Square gun.
I think I might be a teeny bit ahead of you.
Excellent.
Let me attempt to fix that.
Why don't we just say when the fucking title pops on screen?
Yeah. Okay. This is reminding me of CRT Alien Isolation.
The alien game as well. How many
Five
finishes
Nights
do we have?
I was going to say, this is in like space. Five Nights at Freddy's.
There it is. Routine.
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 Poutine. Where's the chips?
Doesn't that look great? That was routine.
No, Jeff.
Yes, Jeff.
Glass half full, sure glass half empty.
I agree. I just don't know what's going on. Guest who's been in his fair share of video games. Look at the ray tracing ball.
Fortnite as the foundation. Fortnite.
Jeff, careful, you're going to fall in.
Oh my god, it's The Rock.
What's up, everybody? Put your shirt on, everyone.
I love that. What's up, everybody? Live
streaming right now. Bro, you're not even looking into the lens.
He's looking at himself.
He's looking at himself. Yeah.
Wouldn't you?
Coming at you from my Iron Paradise, the very hot and sweaty.
And that's a game I want to see. Iron Paradise. Iron Paradise,
powered by, of course,
Zoa Energy, the number one strongest energy drink in the world. This live stream is sponsored by The Rock.
Sponsored by his own drink. Spanish, Uncle Handsome, sexiest man alive,
big drink energy. Oh, he did the thing!
He did the thing! Big drink energy.
I love this man.
He looked over at us.
biggest and most electrifying surprise in gaming.
He's like, who the fuck are these people watching?
It's you watching me.
And I gotta tell you guys, number one, thank you so much for the crazy response of me becoming the foundation, but also, I gotta say that...
He is a pretty good human. I like The Rock.
He is.
Epic Games and, dude's neck is bigger than my head, but...
Dude's nose is bigger than my neck.
In the future, yeah. You will also know me as Black Adam. Black Adam. Oh yeah, Black Adam.
Yeah, promote your shit,
isn't
my
that,
guy.
Isn't there a trailer coming out for that soon?
It's out.
It came out yesterday.
Yeah, it came out yesterday.
Yeah.
Well, it looks
shows how much I pay attention.
Like a DC movie.
That's about right.
It looks. I think it looks more fun than the previous ones. So you do
the math. October 21st, I cannot wait for you guys to see Black Adam.
Halloween movie? In theaters
only. Mate, you said 21st.
Oh.
Stupid.
Oh.
Billy trick-or-treats 10 days early. Why haven't I got any sweets? There's Billy in his little Darth Vader costume.
In his little penguin onesie.
Oh no.
I'm projecting because I went trick-or-treating as Darth Vader as a kid. It's the only time I went trick-or-treating because I was forced to.
Enjoy your gaming.
Oh, here's a trailer for Black Adam. You might not be able to show this on YouTube.com. Just replace
you
it
might
with
be able to.
A black
Actually,
screen.
It's Warner Brothers, you won't be able to show it.
Basically, a black screen and a picture of Adam. Oh, there's guns. Oh, he's floating. Only if I could make a deal with God. These movies confuse me, man.
Yeah.
Like, how do they have fucking... like, floating flyer things when it's... current year?
Is this supposed to be current year?
I assume so, right? Because he's teasing, like, oh, I'm stronger than Superman.
He's teasing that he's, like, on the same level, I think, isn't he?
Yeah, or better, he's saying.
Oh, shooty!
Bold of you
game.
To assume.
Oh, it's the knockoff Destiny. It's fate.
It's fate.
The music's kind of.
Oh, that's big dude.
Oh, is this the Mick Gordon song? It has the energy.
I don't know.
You see what I mean now, though, about everything having a gun in it. So far.
I mean, yeah.
I want to see fun 2D platformer featuring
Boingo. You know what? I
kind of
like
Boingo.
The look of this. I know this is like...
I want Oingo Boingo.
Same. I want Ogda Mogda.
Yeah.
I kind of like the look of this. I need to look into this.
I also like the look of it as well.
It looks like Destiny, but just different.
Venom.
That's Morbius.
It's like in a... It's like a...
That's more Bayonetta.
Nah, she was just
like
Palutena
an arena
down
fighting
smashing.
Game or something. Like an arena shooter, I mean. That's what I'm trying to say.
Yeah.
It just looks like a good co-op game with friends.
Yeah.
Which I love. Woman. Got that adrenaline momentum, woman.
Alright, now show me.
Stadia is still on there.
End game.
For the end game. I wonder if there's going to be any moments we're going to...
Oh, it's the console I know.
Hello. What the hell are they doing here?
Hello.
What if this is the extent of Nintendo we get this year?
If this is the Nintendo Direct, I'll be very upset.
No. Is there anything that we're going to pog at, do you think?
Oh, yeah, the Cuphead DLC. Give it
new.
To me.
I think they're just doing a sizzle reel.
No, I mean like during E3. That's all. The whole
time.
Well,
they might do something after this, you know? That's always the way they usually do it.
Four or five games, and now we got Jesse Cox.
I hate Jesse Cox with a passion, my guy.
It's me.
Oh, it's Fall Guys.
Oh yeah, because it's coming out on Switch. And it's also free to play now as well, I'm pretty sure.
Yes. That's Sykuno. What's Sykuno doing there? Oh, it's just all the streamers. Okay, cool.
I think you're like a second ahead. I was like, what are you talking about?
No, Sykuno was sitting at the coffee table outside. And that was Valkyrie. That's Courage. Was the first dude Pay Money Wubby, or am I wrong? I don't know. Correct me.
I wish I could tell you.
That was B-Tech, that, Jeremy McKinnon.
That's... I thought...
Yeah, I just see man with beard and short dark hair as Jeremy McKinnon.
I don't think they're default.
No, I don't think so either. I like how it suddenly cut and then it was in game. Free for all, June 21st.
The game's already a free for all. Yeah, but now it's free for all.
Now it's actually free.
Free for all, guys. Fall Guys got just destroyed by Among Us. I'm glad it's coming back.
Among Us. It never left.
Well, I'm glad it's like more like, I guess more recognized. I don't know, because it feels like everybody was playing Fall Guys, and then Among Us came out, and it's like Fall Guys just disappeared.
It's a different bean-shaped character.
Among Us definitely fell off.
You say that it fell off, but like you can get merchandise it's still huge. Everywhere. It's like
yeah, they just
Fortnite,
added. They just added into Fortnite.
They added Among Us into Fortnite.
Yeah, you can get an imposter back bling, and you can do the dance from their games. You know, little Henry Stickmin dance.
Is this
another game in space?
Yeah,
with guns on a planet that isn't Earth.
My brain went to Portal, but I don't think it's Portal.
Yeah, I also did as well.
That is not Portal.
It's Rey from fucking Star Wars.
It's the thing from Halo.
It's me, Rey Skywalker.
Commander. Look, she's got her hair. Maybe onto
something. It's Rey, a crystal. It's a Kyber crystal. Oh,
it's a Kyber crystal.
Ah. Oh. Now the lightning's gonna shoot out like a saber of light or something. I don't know, this is a bad joke.
Yeah.
Don't you lecture me with your $40 haircut.
You think I got a haircut?
No, I've seen you.
Just look up, I'm looking down at you right now.
Fucking
I think
spaniel.
She shouldn't have made that little shield thing.
It's summoned Skull!
Oh,
no, that's Black Skull
cool
Dragon.
Demon man. Guy.
Aurora Borealis?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Localized entirely within this small area.
Localized entirely within hell.
Yeah. Hang tight, Doc. I've got this. What's this, Titanfall?
What's this, Half-Life 2?
D.Va from Overwatch?
What is this? True Ogre from Tekken 3. Love this bit. Just what is this game?
I can't think of anything else. I was sitting there trying to think of something.
What is this?
I do think it resembles
Mech Arena.
It does resemble D.Va the most, exactly. What was that? That was like the fucking the Emmys
was
from
that?
Metroid Dread.
Gibbing?
Do you hear that noise? Freaking me
Human
out.
Robot mech suit from a hit movie Avatar.
What is this?
From
Stormgate?
Yeah, what is it? Stormgate?
Ret and Tui?
Register? That says register, Thomas, not register.
I love that. That. This is like a stock like YouTube intro from 2012.
Yeah, it is.
100%. It's a Cinema 4D.
Yeah. Cinema 4D template.
Congratulations. Storm the Gate! Is real. We have a name and details.
So, first of all, congratulations on this announcement. We're so excited. I love how different the floor is from the wall.
What is a Storm Gate, though? All right, it's so snowy. What is a Storm Gate?
What is a Storm Gate?
Oh my god, Tim Hortons. The Infernal Host
What does Meechin mean?
Tim Mortons.
And we saw some hints of some
I mean, floor change. They heard you. From Blizzard
and oh, they did. They went, that looks weird. Change it.
Yeah, like, oh, so Billy doesn't like that. Our first two sessions today,
but there will be more. So the we're not even live. How do they hear us?
Archaeologist what the fuck?
They've tapped your headphones, Bill. You're wearing a wire.
These are wireless headphones.
I want Billy Meechin dead.
Until he tells us what Meechin means, he does not leave this cell.
I don't know what it means.
Of or pertaining to Meech.
Did you just Google it?
No.
What the you're expecting something to come up on Google?
Yeah, I want to know. It's got to mean something.
Pretty sure my name means, like, island.
Big Bird.
I mean, I meant my first name.
Big Bird!
Island very of the Big Birds.
Very big wingspan.
My name is literally Island of Big Bird. We're also really trying to be
a lot more social. Shout out to Big Bird.
I am train.
I really love how we just completely tune out from these talking sections.
Yes.
I don't fucking care. Show me it. Don't tell. Basic storytelling now.
Exactly.
Oh, there you go, picture.
Oh, cool. Stranger Things.
POV, you go into Mount Moon without a rappel.
POV, it's a MOBA after all.
Is it like a real-time strategy? Like StarCraft kind of thing?
It's a MOBA after all. Thank you so much for giving us
your announcement today on Summer Game Fest. Thank you so much for having us here. You're the Storm Gate. Frost Giant, Storm
Gate, keep an eye out for you.
You can be the Storm Gate.
Indie
game announcement that I'm excited
to share with you. High Water. This is dark magic, Tim Morton.
High Water. Good morning, High Water dwellers,
High Water pirates. Holy shit.
I thought it said Argos.
Different. Argos.
That's where he bought the fucking canoe. That the world ended. That's like a canoe. Demagogue.
Well, hey, it looks different.
I know this is the first game we've seen that isn't a shooter, but I absolutely hate games with this fucking art style now.
Oh.
There's so many games that look like this, where it's like, yeah, cel-shaded, cool, it's future-proofed a little, but fucking no detail.
I agree.
And there's always boring fucking music like this.
There's a way you do it that makes it look nice.
Yeah, but like it's like the music is always like this, where it's like, oh, very introspective. I wonder how this will make you feel. Like, I don't fucking care. Make me laugh. Make me enjoy the game. Alpha Rad's house. a pile of garbage. How fitting.
Just a pile of garbage.
God, my fucking theory is proven. He ain't funny.
Damn.
I'm gonna get a tweet from him one day. Just like, what the fuck, dude?
He's even like, I've been watching your smear campaign.
I don't even hate him. It's just funny to hate him.
He's gonna ask you to block him back.
Oh god. I'm collecting the infinity stones of Smash YouTubers. I'm gonna fucking add to my gauntlet. I got the red stone of Aaron Itmar already. I'll get the blue stone of Alpha Rad. Including replaced from Sad Cat Studios. A
Belarusian studio with devs from Belarus and Ukraine. The team had just everything that's not first person or twin stick shooter that they're showing for like 30 seconds.
Yeah,
they probably don't have much time.
The teeny tiny little indie developers.
They didn't even show that one. It's American
Arcadia, where you play. She ain't got no nose.
I like that logo.
You get to play as Trevor.
You get to play as Dan Blazing Phoenix.
What?
Oh no.
Doesn't even look like him.
It's the red stripe.
It was the red stripe, yeah.
It's the black hair, the red stripe.
Now this is a way that you do low poly and make it look nice.
Yeah, a bit more detail.
Yeah. Like, some things are flat, like color. Other things are textured.
Yeah.
There he is.
The art style here looks a bit weird. Maybe a bit of a clash, but ooh, I like that.
Yeah.
Okay, looks a bit better here.
Is this a 2D game? That's what it feels like.
I mean, I can see three dimensions, but maybe.
No, but like a 2.5D, where you just walk maybe through the area.
Maybe. Perhaps.
American Arcadia. Subject on the run on camera 4025. Interrupt
broadcast immediately. There he is. See, this still looks like a little bit cheap, but at least it art, like, whoa, art direction.
Is it? This is, has like, got like unique, a Limbo inside kind of vibe.
Yeah.
Where you're just walking in one direction for the whole game, but they make it fun. Trevor, can you hear me? Be careful and don't make a sound.
Ooh. Don't worry. It's Trevor Slattery. I'm going to get
you out of there. Who the fuck?
Oh,
Dan,
I see it
Blazing
now.
Phoenix is going to help me.
It does look like Dan.
Yeah. Oh, no. Oh, mate, he's on the beach.
Where's your shadow?
For a minute. I lost a breath for a second. I thought it was a crash.
Jeff is not being ray traced.
Jeff has been rendered in real time.
To what?
Sequel?
Yeah, to what?
Fortnite? Hmm?
Gears of War?
Fortnite 2?
Coffee Stain? Coffee 2? Is this Dead Island? This is Dead Island 2, isn't it?
It is, isn't it? Yeah.
This is the Dead Island trailer from like 10 years ago. Oh no.
It's gonna be. If it is, I'm gonna be very amused.
It won't. If it is, that'll be hilarious.
They're like invoking it though. It's like the exact same.
It's the exact same. He's dressed the same way. It's a completely different dude. It looks worse than it did 10 years ago.
Yeah, he's got an incredible stiff
animation.
Does he point
at someone? Yeah, this is exactly the same fucking trailer as Dead Island 2. Oh, it's Goat Scenario.
Oh my god.
That's so funny.
That is clever. That is really well done.
I was like, I recognise this developer, but I can't remember what it's from, and it's from fucking Goat Simulator.
Yeah, I didn't think they owned Goat fucking Dead Island, so I was like really confused. That is a really clever fucking way of
so
doing a trailer.
This is so fucking funny.
That was great.
Who?
Making a trailer by calling out another game studio for not making a game. Three? Wait, when
three?
The second
when
one
the,
come out?
When is it two?
Wishlist now.
That's a joke.
Wishlist it right now, please. Goat Simulator 3, and
it's coming later this year. I didn't even know
that was a fucking great bait. That was fantastic.
Oh no. Why do they all look like Wolverine?
I just love that. Well, one of them I'm assuming that's Ghost Rider or the writer or something, but I love that he's just on fire with the background. He's like, guys, help.
Guys, I'm spreading.
We got Wolverine, we got Iron Man, we got,
Blade.
Alright, Blade. Ghost Rider, don't know what we're going to back is.
Oh, you're gonna have to mute this part, Thomas.
Oh, yep, you will.
I mean, as long as it doesn't get they can get content ID'd all at once. As long as it doesn't get blocked, I don't really care.
Oh, it's a 2K game? Maybe this might be good.
Hmm.
Venom!
He's massive.
Yeah, dude's been hitting the gym.
Dude's been eating all good.
That's green fire. Where'd that come from?
It's Green Goblin.
It's Luigi.
It's
the
final
ghost
smash
of Luigi's past. Oh.
Oh, it's
Venom. I don't think you've got much of a chance, mate.
Your weakness is fire. Why did you run into it?
Fire and sound.
Oh, his tongue.
Look funny about that time. He's like, I won't hurt you.
Spider-Man!
Venom becoming Denoim.
Oh.
I don't know.
Oh. It's Marvel's Spider-Man in Marvel's Midnight Suns.
Yeah.
This, I really wish
I mean,
these games connected to a gem.
But this doesn't look that bad.
I think it's
Big
I'm hoping it's a fucking co-op game.
It probably will be. It's like,
do you think it's gonna be like Ultimate Alliance?
I don't know.
Probably.
I'm hoping it's like Destiny 2 or something.
I like how this like, person just has like a band following them behind the whole time.
Is that fucking Darkseid? Whatever the hell it's is Dino.
It's Dino.
Darkseid.
No, I know he's DC. What's the name of the dude from?
Oh,
hi, Hulk.
Well, they are fucked, I guess.
What's the name of the dude? Is that Scarlet Witch? Oh, hi, Benedict Cumberbatch.
Hey, Benny Bun. Benny Bun.
Justice League. What's the bad guy called in Justice League?
Darkseid.
It is Darkseid?
Yeah.
Or Steppenwolf?
Steppenwolf, that's what I'm thinking of.
Steppenwolf.
One guy looked like Steppenwolf.
When this world is scorched, I will come.
Hi, Cuphead.
Hello! The delicious last course!
Cuphead.
This fucking delicious last course has been talked about for a year now.
Yeah, but do you not remember how long it took for the original game to come out?
I know, but like, fucking pace yourself, lad.
So first of all, Maya, it's really coming?
It's really coming June 30th on all major platforms. We are thrilled.
Well, I'm so thrilled too that I think all the fans can't believe that this is here. And I've been lucky enough to play this actually on my Steam Deck last week.
Don't taunt me.
People are not going to be ready
Jeff.
For how amazing this looks. And the
Jeffrey, free.
I don't even up, Jeffrey. Free.
The visual look, you guys have taken it even to the next level, which I didn't think was possible.
Yeah, we absolutely did. I couldn't pinpoint one thing that we're proud of in this because we really honed our craft, took everything to the next level from animation, the backgrounds, the music, gameplay design, and of course our new playable character, Miss Chalice. I'm very proud
She's
of her.
She's got some Miss lovely Chalice. Fucking bling on.
And
even though this is a deal, a watch is shining, a ring is shining.
Yeah.
It is, definitely.
RTX on.
Get on the island, and there you are, off to this new...
I was drinking water, Billy.
Bosses, lots of secrets to discover. Oh, I really want to play Cuphead again now.
I...
Never played it.
Have never played it,
yeah. Oh, it's so good. It's so tough, but it's so good.
GOG.com.
GOG.com.
YouTube Go Combs.
All right, let's check it out. Cuphead, the delicious last course. Thanks, Maya.
Play that tune. Play that.
Do love me some Cuphead music. Oh.
It's a Aurora
Borealis.
Oh. My God.
What is with this goddamn direct and space and Aurora Borealis's?
I really like this, I can't remember what it's called, finger, which is the shooting thing.
I really
they
like
call
this,
them fingers, finger. Or pointers or something.
Finger guns.
Yeah, finger gun.
He goes bang, bang, bang.
It's a good spreader, you know?
You shot me down. Bang, bang. Ooh. I hit, oh, she's got an ult.
Yeah, got your super move. Charging it up there with a little charge at the bottom.
Oh, man. So what do you think is going to get announced for Smash?
Wow.
Bruh.
Bruh.
Crash could still win.
Bruh.
Now if you want even more Cuphead, and who doesn't, tomorrow we will show you an exclusive look at Season 2 of The Cuphead Show when I co-host Netflix's Geeked Week.
There's a Cuphead show?
Yeah, it's on Netflix.
How did I not know about that?
People been memeing it. There's more Summer Game Fest all weekend long. Not memeing it, but like making memes out of it. Indie showcase with
IM8Bit and Double Fine, then Devolver's Double Marketing Fine? Countdown to
Marketing. Double Digital? Devolver Digital's today as well.
Netflix.
7 a.m. Pacific, 2 p.m. Eastern, with news on Rocket League and the Tribeca Game Showcase. And Sunday, don't miss the Xbox and Bethesda Game Showcase.
As for Nintendo, we don't know.
Now we have some exciting news for Nintendo Switch and PC fans. Ooh,
oh,
about
well,
Neon White,
never mind.
Game where you play
oh, that Bell. Game that they talked about in that leak. To
what?
There was a leak about a potential Nintendo Direct that mentioned this game.
Alright, I heard about Ascending to Heaven, and I just thought of the Kanye West lost the Switch game.
So I'm guessing there's no Direct, it's just this game. Called Neon.
There must
there's
be a direct.
Gotta be a direct. We need a Mario Kart announcement.
Well, if there is, then there's no leak confirming it, because this was right. The like one thing that people were speculating was going to be the like thing that was, you know.
Well, that just
whatever.
That just means that.
It just means that if it's going to happen, it'll happen whenever.
Yeah.
That's a cat.
Another one.
Six pack? What the hell? Getting the beers with the boys. Couple of bevvies with the boys.
Machine Girl Kelly.
That's pretty soon.
You say Machine
it's
Girl
week.
Kelly?
Yep.
Oh, it's Annapurna.
Annapurina.
We've shown you lots of games today made by huge teams. Now it's time for a game made by a single father in Poland. Over the past year,
the fuck?
On some help.
Why that sounded so funny?
Game. He had when
he
a
said
divorce.
It's because he said a single father.
A single father.
If he just said by one dad, I'd been fine.
One dad.
But he had to say a single father. It's just like, oh. Maybe he should look after his kids instead of coding 24/7.
Among Us.
Instead Among of making us. Dish game where you're fighting
yeah.
people.
I mean, it looks pretty good to say one dude made it.
He's probably been at this for a while. Is that the Joker?
It's the Joker, baby.
The stink of corruption. Schmelly.
Nintendo Direct is rumored for next week.
Yeah.
Specifically Wednesday, June 15th.
Stuntman for
date.
God of War? Okay. Okay.
A cool hi, bud.
Hey, Jeff, how's it going?
He was just staring at the camera.
Next Fest. Oh, no.
What's wrong with Warframe? All things
Warframe? It's not Destiny.
I'm so good, my fellow Canadian.
I know, we got like.
Look, the Infinity Gauntlet.
I was gonna make that joke, and you beat me to
Thanos.
I was gonna say it 10 seconds ago, but I couldn't.
So was I, but then she was on the screen. And then,
getting it, so it's very exciting.
Damn, she's thick.
Loud and proud, Protea. 30 minutes for watching. Thank you for letting
the game character, not the human being.
Yeah,
I'm not a weirdo.
Oh.
No, Warframe, you know, as I said, we've done a lot over the years. You guys have done incredible things with the game, and I know you have TennoCon coming up in July, which is your big kind of event of the year to reveal what's next. What can you tell us?
Well, I can't tell too much. Yeah, July 16th.
And why are you here?
It's a digital event again this year. Today, actually, we just launched the digital items for it, so you can get some in-game goodies, some really cool cosmetics, some merch, all that really great stuff went live today. But of course, the reason I'm here is to, you know, kind of debut. We have our Tenno Live during TennoCon, which is our big reveal of the night. And
Tenno Live.
Usually do a little bit of a game.
TennoCon.
A demo,
Tenno. Ten.
Those are the most confusing genes I've seen in my life.
What do you mean?
Just look at them.
Can I say it?
What? There's long.
It does look
long,
like they're covering
they're wide,
the whole belly.
And they're like, you know what, let's make him a little bit edgy and Ronnie rip a little bit of one side.
Yeah.
It's a very odd choice. Like, are you rebellious? Are you quirky? Are you normal? Who are you,
are you
Megan?
Explain this fashion choice.
With a cardigan?
It's normal.
Oh my god, his face is in color.
Oh my god, I can see him. His
it
face
like
is Kit Harington.
It looks like the Mandalorian.
Or Pedro Pascal.
Why's he got a horse? a robot horse.
This is another game on another planet.
No, it's just Warframe.
With guns.
This game already exists, though, you know, it's not new.
But why'd they have to show another game on another planet with a gun?
With a gun? Maybe, oh. I don't know.
Tenno.
That went away too quickly, and all I read was for a free tit.
Hell yeah. A hood.
The stranger's hood.
Keep watching, you'll get some items. Hey!
Anime?
Honky Starfall!
Honky!
Oh, Honkai Star Rail.
Even Jeff's aware of the space. This studio continues to deliver, and this new trailer reveals for the very first time. A lot of space today.
Honky
space. Jeff Keighley's big space adventure.
Yeah, big adventure in the great beyond.
Jeff Keighley's Attack of the Honkies. Hoya!
Oh no.
I hate my impulse to just speak.
Hiyo.
Yo, it's Soul Worker.
Looks like Star- yeah, it looks like Soul Worker, what the fuck? But like, with a budget. Maxim's gonna message us in like 2 years, like, do you want to play Honky Star Rail?
She came out of the letterboxing.
I know, that's cool, I love that shit.
Oh, I love it when they do a weird 3D effect.
I love it when they mask over the...
yeah.
Over their own borders that they created.
Yeah.
It's like a Twitter ad that makes it feel like it's coming out of the phone.
Oh, he's been stabbed.
Oh, he's been shanked. He's in ends.
Stabbed with a glowy.
She pushed the cube into his chest.
They want to be Final Fantasy so
bad. Oh my god. It's Optimus Prime.
I thought that's what you were getting at. I just couldn't confirm. This Overwatch?
It looks like a Crash
level. Same game.
It does look like a Crash level.
Like a Crash 4
Speaking
level.
Of Crash, that's not Crash.
Don't say that.
Zenless Zone Zero. Their next
major new IP. ZZZ.
This is putting me to sleep. Thank you.
That was a funny joke, guys.
I do funny. I do like that lime looking ice cream.
I like the Fall Guys character in the car.
I like the skateboard and the helmet.
Oh, it's Goku!
Hey, is that a cat
this
person?
This animation... I know it's only silhouettes, but this animation looks fine already.
I'm getting real Genshin Impact vibes from these characters.
Yeah, of course.
It's
Soul Worker free!
It's Soul Worker, but again. I do love a good anime.
Whatever that said, I didn't read it. I couldn't read it.
I do love it when anime games have weapons that are really weird.
I do like a good slashy game.
That Demon Slayer game comes out on Switch like tomorrow.
Ooh.
Been out on PS5 and everything for a while.
Oh, shit. That's Dan.
It's Dan. I was just gonna say it's Dan's furry OC.
I love how the song was just constantly going, alright, alright.
Alright. Alright. See what's gonna happen next, okay.
Oh, trailer's not over yet.
Welcome to shop.net.
Welcome to
Quiz
shop.
Ah!
Ooh,
I know them.
Hey, I recognize these people. People.
Where's Casey Jones? Well, it's nearing the end of
development, and the team wanted to use SGF as a way to reveal one
exciting aspect of the game. Was Casey even in the original?
I don't
know. Based on the older ones.
I'm not a ninja man.
I feel like
Master Splinty. Oh, there he is.
There he is.
There we are.
I didn't even know Splinter was in this.
Hell yeah. It's the Mousers.
I've never been into Ninja Turtles, but like, I like these kind of games.
Beat him up, you know?
Yeah. When's that Crash beat him up that's apparently rumored? Can't wait to see that.
Well, we just watched a trailer for this game, like, the other day. What did we watch the other day that had this in?
State of Play.
Oh. Well, I didn't watch that with you guys.
Six player mode.
Ooh!
Yeah, plays everyone.
Yo, this is going to be an interesting recording session.
I am very down to do that.
Oh, it's Bebop and Cowboy.
Bebop and Cowboy. Yeah,
it's
get it, Mikey.
Rocksteady and Batman.
That looks fun. I love the sprite work.
Hmm.
I'm into it.
He's gaming.
It's a Game Boy. Game Boy.
Oh, available on Game Boy.
Oh!
That's
pretty
soon.
Really
like
soon.
A week.
Super people.
GG!
Playing chess.
So what are we getting the Turtles game on? Computer?
Computer? You can run it.
Was it on the computer?
Yeah.
Probably. If it's not, then we'll just get whatever can output it highest.
I'm pretty sure it said Steam, so...
Oh my god, that's a 10p coin! Why is it gold? That's the most unrealistic thing I've seen in these games yet.
They went, we're not even allowed to make fake digital versions of money.
It's a Bitcoin.
It's a Bitcoin?
It's a Britcoin.
It's like buying Bitcoins and you get a physical coin.
I should do that.
Damn, they really just said ass shot and then big fart to fly into the air.
Someone, don't throw away that cigarette. There's still so much left in it.
Bruh.
Yeah, come on, man.
It didn't even look lit. My guy was just chewing on sponge for the look.
Super
people.
Oh! Cigar!
Oh!
Oh, civilization, but not.
Oh.
That's not a phrase that sounds fun. That sounds low-key like a... like a bad thing. Do you want to play with some six new cultures?
Alright,
cause us a Latin revolution.
You want to fuck around with six unique Latin cultures?
But wait,
there's more!
A seventh Latin culture?
What the heck? They're real people.
Rewrite history?
Was that Rory Williams?
Well, you know, I shouldn't have said a Latin revolution because they actually meant it. They were like, yeah, sure, okay. Conceptually, I like the idea. I always love a bit of alternate history.
I love a little meddling with time, me.
No, I'm just going to play Sonic.
Yes, giant horses.
We'll push humankind so far, we've got big people.
We've got large fucking people. And they all animate the same run cycle.
That's like every game.
Oh no.
Sega!
Sega ball.
The Sega eyeball, like, jump scares me every time I see it.
Yeah. I'm with you.
The Sega eyeball, if you will.
Oh!
Here we go, on the rails, and oh, it's time to raise our sails, because a pirate ship. Monkey DeLuffy.
DeLuffy.
He really just said Monkey DeLuffy.
Oh look, it's the boyfriend ball. I know it's his arm,
boyfriend ball. That was a JRPG. Okay.
Huh.
Journeying along the ground. I wonder if this looks good as well. I've noticed One Piece games always look great.
They do. despite me knowing nothing
about them. Yeah.
Yeah.
I wish Dragon Ball got this kind of beautiful game.
Well, I feel like Dragon Ball and One Piece are like the two anime that get like loads of fucking media.
Mm. Yeah, but Dragon Ball stuff kind of gets like
we make a fighting game because it's the game where they fight people.
Yeah, it's either like reused or kind of like a bit rushed.
Yeah.
And it's always the same thing. It's like play through the story.
Yeah.
From the show.
Frankie.
Nami. Ooh,
Smash Brothers.
Chopper.
Tony.
Tony. Luke. Usopp. I know him. Woman.
Like Zoro. Six arms.
Sanji? I know more about this than I thought I did.
Yeah, you do.
Luffo.
Monkey.
Luffus. Big hand.
Really punched a cloud.
Why does it look Final Fantasy VII with the fucking text coming on?
It's got like a Dragon Age vibe with the like art style.
Oh, I was thinking Dragon Quest XI.
Maybe it is.
That's what I meant.
Maybe it's developed by Square. Because I think they're normally done by
Dragon Age.
They're normally done by Bandai Namco. So if this is done by Square, then that would make a lot of sense.
It would.
Here we go.
Well, there we go.
Off the rails.
Oh, he's in the desert. Two from Atlas
launches, and we've got your first listen to the English voice cast with this quick new look.
First listen.
Who cares? My brother in Christ, Jeffrey. Who asked?
Ringo.
Paul. John. George.
No more fan mail.
These were the ingredients created. I'm warning you with peace and love, Ringo. Stop sending me fan mail.
Stop sending me voice lines.
It's a complete reversal. It's just Ringo has been sending fan mail to this one girl.
That looks like a mix of pirate and...
You get one more chance
to
report.
True.
Also, I love that I finally got my wish to get away from all the gun games, and now it's just all anime games.
Yeah, thanks, man.
Yep.
Soulworker hackers!
Is this what you wanted?
To live
Mirror Hen
in a house that is haunted? Nerd Wallet. Okay, these marketing things are getting too close to home. Is going on
right now. Yeah,
who the fuck are you? Off top PC titles with an additional 25% off eligible products. So 100%.
Yeah, that's how it works.
Yeah.
I can do math.
Oh, this game where you play as a shark.
It's a big fish.
But with sharks.
What the heck? What's our PC doing?
It's running games.
How dare
playing Crisis.
Computer.
What's your computer doing?
It's Sprocket League.
That looks Sprocket like Vanilla League. Piece. Look
it's
like
Psycho Bort.
What?
Is this is like the Samsung font.
It is.
So I don't know what
it's
gonna the hell
be
this is gonna
it's
be.
Gonna be the Samsung Vive or whatever the fuck. Oh yeah, TV.
Yeah, it might actually be. Yeah.
Samsung Gaming Hub.
You could just turn on your Xbox and all your games would be there as well.
Well,
I've never
met anyone who has a problem with like switching console or like turning on their computer. Like all these companies are like, oh, what if we made it super easy and put them all in one spot? It's like no one gives a shit.
I would like there to be some kind of unified service where I can have like my Steam account and my Nintendo account and my PlayStation account and everything all together. Just so you can see like into every game I own.
Yeah,
I
get
have
the
like,
unified
appeal. Place for all my
but
PC
I want an
games,
official
like
thing.
It.
I want like an official thing where it's like you can see all my achievements across the games.
Is Capcom cool. releasing a classic game collection with Street Fighter 1?
Oof.
All right.
Block.
Oh no, Street Fighter.
Hyper Street Fighter.
Mega Man. Mega Man the Power Fighters 2. Okay.
Pow.
Oh my god, a Son Goku.
Ooh. Oh. Oh, are we gonna get more? I mean this
pretty
is
sure
literally
the same trailer we've already seen.
Yeah, it's literally coming out tomorrow. You're
gonna get hit. This game coming out tomorrow. In Mario Strikers
Battle League. Wait, tomorrow? Yeah. I get paid tomorrow.
Oh shit.
I don't. I have to wait till next week.
I forgot you can't see me. I just pointed in this pog. I've been pogging, like, often. I'm just forgetting you can't see. Is that Markiplier?
I thought it was Jake Gyllenhaal. You know how
in some games for the music to oh, no. you feel compelled
to move and shoot to Jake Gyllenhaal. But what if you had to?
Yeah.
In metal, the better you are at slaying to the metal, the more intense everything gets. And with vocal and legendary artists like Serge Tankian from System of a Down. Ooh. So while headbanging isn't
mandatory, we do recommend
it. I want this game. What is it? On
Steam, yeah, I'm also interested exclusively by Serge.
Ooh.
Oh, I think I've actually got this.
It's like, what's it? I can't remember the name of the game, but it's like that game with the angel screaming on the cover.
Yeah, I've got that one.
Yeah.
Bullets per minute is what it's called, I'm pretty sure.
Bullets per minute, yeah. Is that but metal as fuck? Let's go. Hopefully the music is a...
I really do like these games because they're great fun.
Wait.
Yo!
I'm trying to look at these names, see if I recognize any of them.
Well, someone was from Soulwork.
Trivium.
Lamb of God.
Lamb of God? Yo.
Oh, I love it.
Got some metalcore in there as a joke. Of course. The king.
There he is, yeah. The one and only.
I think to end it with like Jack Black. Hey, yeah! Funny.
Why did they leave the keys upon the table?
They wanted to.
They wanted to create another fable.
Metal.
Metal Hellsinger.
Metal Hellsinger. Oh, wow.
Nice.
Nice. That's a flag.
Seconds of logos. Ding.
That one was metal. Shut the fuck up.
Go away.
You did a CinemaSin thing earlier. Right now, as you mentioned, a demo has launched on PC,
Xbox, and PlayStation for you to play for free. I'm interested. I might go download that.
Yeah, give it a look.
Yeah, that's not if it's any good. Until
Dawn, all right. David Arquette and an
all-star cast. Yeah, you could do it too. And this is
one of those move can do. Worthy teen horror entertainment
experiences. You can do it too. We can do.
With cancer! I can't scream. I can't do anything.
That was a bit intense.
My throat is gone. Oh. Family?
Is that a documentary?
Lucky there's a family guy. Every last one of them decided to jump down the bottom of a well and they're all just
hanging on the end of a rope. Here I go downloading Metal Hellsinger demo.
But you pull on that rope and you're just gonna fall right down to the bottom of the well with the rest of them. And what's the point of that?
Don't look into the camera with your dead eyes.
Yeah, please. You can only uphold the
Is that fucking Brenda wait, song from the Sweet
this
Life
is,
of Zack Cody?
Wait, yeah.
This is like the fucking what's it called? You have no idea what's
going on here. Hang about, I just seen London fucking Tipton.
Yeah, and I saw what's-his-face from Detective Pikachu.
This is the Until Dawn people, isn't it? I just realised.
Perhaps.
Yeah, Justice.
It looks really like one of their games. What I hope is that they actually make a full-length game.
That is 100% London Tipton.
That's Brenda's song for sure.
That is.
That's the only two that I recognize, though.
I like the Friday the 13th.
What?
Font. The
rules, you noob. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it is.
You hear that?
I don't like how he said noob, yeah. That was horrible.
Them's the rules, you noob.
Canada.
No.
Now it's time to give you a brand new look and deeper look at the game, including its innovative realm card.
Notice how small he looks right
now. He does look like a man.
Small. He's shadow. He's got shadow.
The little man. Oh, he does.
Ray traced man.
Oh, here's Goat Simulator 2.
You're alone in the realms.
Ah,
there he is.
Of course.
Not even sure if Nightingale made it.
Berries. You just took the whole fucking bush.
Yeah.
It's a survival game. Well, I haven't seen where I am before.
Staying fed, dry, and rested should be your priority.
It's rust, but you've got clothes.
Ooh. It's like rust, but with like a Victorian era aesthetic.
I never said I'd let them in.
He's got a light ball on his head. That's a shotgun.
It is, Billy.
Yeah.
Trading cards.
Oh my god. I can't wait spider. To play Yu-Gi-Oh! Against the monsters. I summon a skull.
I don't like spiders, Harry.
Why couldn't it be follow the butterflies?
Harry, I hate the bloody spiders.
Imagine my shock.
Imagine my shock. I walk into the Forbidden Forest and I see Aragog. Aragog.com.
Oh, hello. Oh.
He says he doesn't want to hurt me.
Hey, who
turned out the lights?
Motherfucker. Hey, who turned out the lights? Oh. Is that the same guy? Same people?
That's not possible. Again.
Saints are marching in on August 23rd. Saints Row?
Yeah, this has been about for a while. It's a bump truck. It was a bum. Since it's Saints Row, you guys are going to have
a lot of fun with this one. Check it out. She's bumping the trunk.
Shut up.
Wow.
Oh. You got to do something to capture people's attention. So what do we build next? Man, we're going through regeneration real fast.
Yeah.
The time is child.
You're wasting that cycle pretty quickly.
Oh god! Sense at the
pee-wee. Oh my god!
They're like, Cyberpunk can do it, why can't we?
Yeah.
Be the swaggiest.
I hate this.
This game is gonna suck. I swear to god, if they floss, this game's done.
Tinfoil hat! I like how it's just constantly changing the player character. It looks so odd. Oh, okay.
He's just a fucking guy! Just like, for reference, here's man.
This is how you make man. This is how you make woman.
This is how you make Morbius.
Don't wait, yeah, oh, sorry.
This is how you morb. I bet you the chat just says fucking Morbius.
Yeah.
Morbius, 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 Morbius.
Oh, yeah.
I feel like this is the last game.
I feel like we've been saying that for a while with Saints Row.
I mean, this is the last game of the show.
Oh. I feel like it really isn't the last game of the show, but I could be wrong.
I'm in the trunk. Download now.
Free. Oh, it's a demo,
Boss
isn't
Factory,
it?
Whatever that is.
I think that's literally just where you make your character, so when the full game comes out, you've got them ready.
Oh, there is another one.
Next, we've got an exclusive first look at extended gameplay of Warhammer 40K Darktide.
I'm pretty sure Jeff would say this is the final announcement.
He would.
Darktide promises intense four-player co-op action and terrifying...
Jeff wouldn't let us down like that.
Four-player co-op has been a fucking theme in the Warhammer games. I know nothing about them. We need to do some research.
My man is dressed like the ninth doctor.
I have no idea.
I know Vermintide's meant to be fun.
Oh, Vermintide is fun, actually. I have Vermintide 2.
It's like a Left 4 Dead kind of game.
It's just Left 4 Dead, but with orcs.
Of rats. Fat char.
Yeah.
Get in. Didn't say about getting you out.
I didn't say anything about getting you in.
That's a big fella.
He is a fucking big fucking
Roadhog
guy.
Rides again.
Oh, he's a big fella. Look at him. He's so high up.
Listen, co-op game, we need to write this down.
Oh, you hit him right in the ass and split him in half.
God, you went British for a second.
It's almost as if I am.
No.
Split him in half, he did.
Oh, it's your skull with a fucking glasses.
It's a skull spider.
Oh, Sigma male.
Imagine my shock. Oh my god.
Imagine my shock. I'm a skull and you put fucking eyes on me.
I don't think
imagine
the big fella needed your help
when I'm
there,
a 10-foot tall big guy.
Imagine my shock. Everyone else is half my size. I thought this was normal here.
Every game has added this like little dash in ever since Doom did it. It's a good move, so I'm not even going to complain. But
yeah.
Oh my god, it is Rhino from big... Amazing Spider-Man 2.
I was gonna say that. He's a big man there. Bloober
team is known for psychological
no.
Is it Bloober?
Bloober?
It did Bloober like team. Bloober team. UE5. It's a return to the world of
Layers of Fears. Get a dose of this.
Dose. Is that supposed to be a joke?
As in Uno, Dose, number two.
Finally, Dose. Bloober. I'm pretty sure that already exists.
It does.
So I'm
not... Yeah.
Finally, Trace.
Oh no, the door.
Oh no, painting with dust on it.
A clean
piano.
Yeah.
Oh, there it goes.
There it goes.
I've played Mario 64. I know what happens next.
Oh my god, it's the Final Fantasy Meteor, but in blood.
Did you see that Smash 64 mod that added the mad piano as a playable character?
I did see that, yeah.
I think I did, yeah.
It's incredible.
Rats and a wheelchair.
What's he doing in there?
Oh!
Yeah, I'm probably gonna pass on this one.
Yeah, I'm not a spooky dude. Wait,
I can be a spooky dude, but usually, don't like video games that are spooky.
Yeah.
Yeah, because you're in control of it.
Yeah, it's just because I'm playing it, basically.
Listen, I'm a bitch, alright? I've never managed to play fucking Bioshock. I love Infinite. So I'm a bit of a weakling, me.
I won't even play FNAF.
I would never.
I probably wouldn't either. I don't really like the jumps.
FNAF is like the antithesis of that, because it's just cheap jump scares. Like, you're already stressed out, and then they add the cheapness on top, so it's just like, okay.
Like, I'll watch it any day. Like, I really enjoy Markiplier's videos on it, because I just think he makes it funny, but...
Listen, jump scares are one thing, because it could just be, like, something appearing on screen suddenly.
Yeah.
They all say add to wish list now.
They could slowly walk into your screen, you're like, oh, shit.
Oh, this
but,
game.
But, like, with FNAF, they jump quickly into your screen and then scream,
yeah.
And then flap their fucking mouths open like a fucking clam.
And then you get a little static cut.
Hello and warm welcome from WB Games Montreal.
I've heard this game isn't great, but I hope it
Hello,
is.
Hello, I am French Canadian.
Hello, I am French.
Marty!
One of our beloved
Marty!
Nightwing.
We gotta go back to the Robin!
Her name's like a YouTube poop noise.
Flair.
Flair. It's a character of Harry Potter 4, man.
On October 25th. Oh. So I hope
she's like,
it is.
You saved my sister! Thank you! And you helped!
He's like, a bit.
Oh, yeah, a bit.
And then kisses him and he goes,
mercy. Bloody hell.
Gotham
gave me
everything. Bloody got ham. It deserves to be got ham. Nits. Nits? Fucking hell. Goat ham.
What are you aiming at?
He is the knight. Wing.
Oh, there's his wings.
There's his wings.
Nightwing duck.
And now, ooh, they're doing flippies. It's up to me.
He's got long hair.
Sub-Zero ass.
It's that Arrow Man from Overwatch. And there's Roadhog.
That's Reinhardt. Just B-Tech Reinhardt.
Oh, Roadhog doesn't have a shield.
I got this, Bruce.
Thought that said Bruce Willis.
Cause of death.
When I was Deadpool for a second, it's Deathstroke.
I just said lack of family. That's not Bruce Willis, is it?
No, it's Neil Druckmann. He's going to announce The Last of Us. Even though it's been announced.
Oh, yeah. Even though it just got leaked a minute ago. An eventful
day on the internet for Naughty Dog. I'm getting Bruce Willis and Vin Diesel mixed up. Which one's which? We were joking about last night, like, watch the assets leak, and yes, lo and behold. Hello. Well, the good news is there's
some stuff that hasn't leaked that we have lots to share with you about. Ooh, factions? Naughty
Dog, but... First of all, it is a, you know, it's a big Please? Month actually for Last of Us fans because well, I like how they acknowledge the leak. June and
nearing its 2-year anniversary for Last of Us part 2, which is hard to believe. Yeah, it's crazy.
Well, we're all old and time is going way too fast. Part 2 and
we still hear from fans. Dr. Uckman. And art and these characters in this
journey and this world mean so much to them. Dr. Uckman.
It's so weird that like the trolls call him Cuckman. Like just
it's because he made a game with women in Sid.
I know. And it's like that's got nothing to do with it.
Oh, that's got everything to do with it to those people.
Yeah, exactly. It's like our connection women he allowed women to exist.
He allowed women to have feelings. Cuck.
Dude looks like he fucks, so.
Yeah, he probably does.
Multiplayer mode has evolved due to the team's ambition. Oh. Really wanted to do something. Here we go.
I'm excited for you, Sid, to be honest.
Billy, why did you
send a standalone title?
Bill, why did you send a less than 1 second video?
Did you not hear the sound?
No, I heard that. Oh, what?
Okay. Yeah, so, we have a it's just, start that we want to show. I sent it before the stream and went, Sid, dissect this half a second video that I just found on my computer. This game is
big. Okay. It's evanescent.
Big. Excuse me? The way we're telling that story is very unique to this game. It's got a brand new cast of characters. It takes place at another place, another part of the United States. It's like a city might be somewhat familiar to some people. I'm sure our fans have already figured it out.
Well, that's the Golden Gate Bridge, isn't it, mate? It's really cool. I think.
I'm pretty sure it might be a Golden Gate Bridge.
Think it might. Why is it red? Why is it not golden? All veterans of
Uncharted and Last yeah, what years. Happened? And you're going to see a
lot more of this game. False advertising, eh? Next year to
hear more about that. Okay, well, very exciting that this has evolved, and I mean, that concept art looks incredible. I can't wait to see Naughty Dog storytelling fused with multiplayer live games.
I'm glad we've got something. I'm glad they've
told
me something.
Okay, well, I think that's more interesting than just a multiplayer mode.
I've been reading about it on the internet every day. It feels like up in Calgary, they're filming the Last of Us show for HBO, right?
Yeah, oh, so, a show?
Last of Us HBO show.
Do you know who's playing Joel? The Mandalorian.
Chris Pratt.
Mr. Pedro Pascal.
Chris Pratt.
No, he's playing Ellie.
That makes sense.
It's Chris Pratt.
Here's my Ellie voice. It's a me. Ellie.
Ellie.
I couldn't be proud of, like, again, Craig and that whole crew and everybody that's up there.
Was it just fans who thought that Ellie was, like, based on Elliot Page, or did they actually get offended by it?
It was kind of actually they had to change it.
Right.
Yes, oh. I think that really speaks to the kind of collaboration and trust that exists between Naughty Dog and HBO that they invited me to direct one of the episodes. I think we have an image from the episode I actually directed.
Ooh, okay. So we could first look. Let's take.
Oh, there he is.
See, this is a certain.
There he is.
GM that players might know from the game.
Oof. Oh no! Even I know about that certain museum.
That's very early in the game.
Yeah. It's so early on I know about it because I got to that point.
Where's Grogu?
That's Grogu right there.
It's Grogu.
I couldn't help but think about Troy Baker and Ashley Johnson. It felt so similar to the chemistry those two actors had when we made the game. And it really feels like this is going to be something special. And I will say this will be the most authentic video game adaptation yet.
Well, I mean, that first image that they put out, it just feels like
video game. Imagine it's going to be with Sonic.
I feel like it's going to be fairly easy to do it with The Last of Us, because it's like, just follow the story.
A movie anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They just did the Uncharted movie. How are they going to do it like that? Are they going to say that?
They're doing themselves in the foot
Uncharted
like that.
The Uncharted movie shit.
Yes.
Actors from the show who are going to join us here.
Happen to have a couple actors here that are.
We got Pedro.
Okay. Come on up.
Oh, that music got really loud all of a sudden.
Wait a minute.
Oh, hello.
He's back.
Hang on a second.
I'm a little confused.
It's Gretchen from Recess.
Pedro Bello, but Troy Ashley out here from the game, right?
So when Craig and I started working on the show.
Yeah, so we're dubbing over the human beings with the video game voice actors.
Oh, if they say that,
I'd be down.
Filled with pain.
Create Joel and Ellie. We felt like it was so important that they become part of the show. And it wasn't, it has to be more than just like kind of like a wink to the camera and like a cameo.
Okay.
These are real roles that we're keeping under wraps for now.
Uh-huh.
But man,
that's cool. I like that.
You guys when you filmed your stuff.
There's been so much stuff
so,
I feel like
so good.
On the internet, there's so much like talk about what's being filmed, and I think that's.
It's like when they put like
a
real life actor's family member in a show. You know?
Troy is going to be the Doctor. Not the Doctor Who. Don't
fuck me up. I was like, huh?
Troy is going to be the Doctor at the surgeon.
Yeah.
The Proctor. The helicopter.
He's going to be bumping out them slaughter medic sounds that keeps him dead.
keeps him dead, yeah. Every person that I met on that crew
is such Ashley's going to play knew what it was that they were working on and committed to working on this project because of their I don't know
and their love for the game
Death Star or the Cobra Kid.
I was coming home to friends.
It's coming home.
It's there.
The crew was amazing. Bella and Pedro are
people.
They're so perfect.
Yeah.
And we've been trying to sort of describe that feeling of sort of seeing them in person. It's like the characters coming to life, but it's so much more than that. I feel like I can't fully explain it, but I am so excited.
It's like a TV show with actors.
It's like a real life thing with real life people.
It's almost as if it exists now.
I love the story. I love just being a part of
it. I'm so excited about the series and the fact that you guys are going to be in it and undisclosed roles. I'm so fascinated how it's going to sort of bob and weave and you know, are these characters
cameos
in the game that they're playing? Can you tell us anything?
I'm going to have to say it right now.
I can tell you.
So sneaky. All right. Well, we're so excited.
Maybe it's already on Twitter by now.
Let's talk about what we've done.
I love that they call that out.
Lots of talk about the idea, but really what's happening is it looks like you guys are remaking the original game, and this is like a ground-up remake. Is that right?
That's right. We wanted to give people the definitive version of the first game.
Didn't they already remaster it once?
Yep.
Yep, they did.
Closer to our original vision, and we're able to do it on the PS5.
NPC and oh, I've got a platinum this fucking game again.
They really don't care if I want it. They really don't care if I buy a PS5, do they?
I really struggled. I streamed myself platinum in this game on the hardest fucking difficulty, and it was hell. I've been on quite the adventure, little brother. Maybe this is my call. Maybe this is what I gotta do to come back.
What, platinum the game again?
Yeah, fuck it. Grounded Plus, let's go.
I will say, it does feel like a waste to do it so soon after. I've never been this close. You know? It's the outside.
Oh, is that everything you hope for? I'm hoping they don't make. I know they're gonna make changes to the story, like a little bit, the ending. They're gonna have it make it more of a connective thing. Oh. I hope they don't change too much. Once upon a time, I had somebody that I cared about. And in this world, that's good for one thing: getting you killed.
I can take care of myself. How many close calls have we had? I get in trouble down there. You make every.
No, I'll take an excuse to play this game again.
I
got this.
I want to say I played the original for like 5 minutes.
Then you've not played the original. You know what? This fixes my problem I was talking about earlier, though.
Yeah, it'll be in the right order in your library now.
Yeah. On the PlayStation library, it's like part two is first, then remastered is second.
Remastered, yeah.
Performances you did a decade ago. Yeah. You didn't go back in. I mean, you used the original performances.
Yeah, actually, we came up with a process where we could take the original animation that we did for the faces and kind of like retarget it on these new rigs that have a lot more fidelity. And then the animators went back and
we're
studied
side by side.
That's wild.
How much it has changed.
Yeah.
You went and you redid the models and rebuilt everything.
Everything was rebuilt from the ground up. Same art director, re-art directed the whole thing.
That is a handsome man right there.
But the great thing about these faces is that they're closer to the original performance. All the animators went and studied those videos and got it closer to what you did on set than we could have achieved before. And that's just like one of the things we could talk about, like this brand new AI, like all the combat is redone. The fidelity of everything, 60 frames per second, all the stuff you're getting on the PS5. Again, we wanted to give
60 frames per second. Like that's a selling point now.
Players for PS5 and PC.
Yeah. I want my 120.
I have never even seen 120 frames in my life, and I want to know what it looks like.
When you see it, you'll get it. My main monitor is 144.
You know how to describe? I know how to describe 120 FPS to you. You know when you go into a store and you look at like the TVs on display, and they always look really smooth, like smoother than any TV you've seen.
Yeah,
that's because they're more likely running in 120.
Okay.
It's really when you play it, when you see it in motion. It's
I'm glad I can actually play this in 4K. So that's good.
That, you know, think of the Last of Us 2 combat, but kind of that back in the Last.
Well, it's the whole. I'm glad that they're making a PC version. AI system, everything
we've learned on like on four
Last of Us. People are gonna mod it.
I'm thinking about it. Just to give
a quick custom Last of Us maps.
I'll mod it. Ellie can wear a PAL shirt. That was a plan I wanted to do. I wanted to low key every PC game I played modding up. I'll look at somewhere.
Games directed by other people. What are you directing? You still making games?
Still making games. I haven't given up my day job. It's a little early to talk about it. Maybe if someone in PlayStation wants to leak it, then we could talk about it now.
Someone in PlayStation wants to leak it.
We have a new project, but we'll save it for another Summer Game Fest.
Okay. Okay, well, we'll see. We'll try and save it. All right.
Jeff.
Thank you so much for dropping by.
Trying your best, buddy.
I'm so excited that The Last of Us is returning.
It's Jeffrey Calefrey.
So thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Jeff.
Awesome.
That must have been the last
one,
surely. All
right, well, that is going to do it.
Thanks to Naughty. Yeah. Oh, well, there we go.
Special look at The Last of Us and the entire franchise and where things are going.
No crash.
All right, Summer Game Fest continues over the next
few days. Hey, we still got Activision and Blizzard. Not Activision, Blizzard. Microsoft and Bethesda. Double
Fine, including an exclusive. That's probably where they'd show it anyway now, anyway, right? Because they bought...
Isn't the Devolver Digital one starting right now?
Is it?
I think so. I think so.
Oh god.
I don't think they're gonna show anything good anyway.
Oh, but Devolver Digital's one's always quite fun.
Yeah, they're always funny.
As for me, I'll see you again in August when we are back live in Cologne, Germany for Gamescom opening night live on August
23rd. Oh yeah, Gamescom.
And then the Game Awards will return in December live.
Hey, Jeff Keighley's big day out.
Jeff Keighley announcing all of his rest of his year's appearances.
Hey! Day in the Sun 2023! Community together.
Thanks for being a part of Summer. Hey.
And remember, there are more announcements to come. See you soon.
Goodbye, ninth doctor looking ass.
Goodbye, Jeffrey.
Fantastic.